305 Fights, where champions rise.
Donde suben los campeones. We are here with a positive influence on our team membership, and welcome to the 305 Fights team. KMar or KMar, how would you say it?
KMar.
KMar, your full name?
My full name is Kevin Darnell Marine.
Kevin, we wanted to bring you on to our podcast show, 305 Fights TV, where the champions rise. Because you're a personal trainer, physical instructor, talk about the sports, but most of all is because I love your positive. I like what you're doing. You're really promoting the idea of 305 Fights. And like I told you, I believe that what you focus on expands.
Amen.
So we want to focus on that and rise together. So thank you so much.
Thank you for having me.
Tell us a little bit about you, how you got into sports, strength and conditioning and everything.
So it all started 2008. I graduated college in 2007. Believe it or not, I majored in business management, right? So I went into the fitness aspect because I was home, you know, like most college grads, nothing to do. Started working out, became a personal trainer, certified, was working at the YMCA. From that, I ended up using my business degree and becoming the GM of a GNC. So now I'm in a cesspool full of supplements. So I learned the nutrition supplement side, sports nutrition side. And from that, it just kind of, you know, snowballed into me becoming a strength and conditioning coach. Started off with NFL players, then got more into combat sports.
Excellent. You know, now you say NFL players and combat sports. We have part of our team, we have management companies like Reach Combat, Dodge Sports, and they handle NFL and combat sports like MMA, boxing, because believe it or not, I consider football a combat sport.
Of course.
Because it's definitely a contact sport.
Oh, yeah.
So there's a lot of things that we're going to get into. We're going to get into the realm of strength and conditioning, nutrition. We wanted to know, first of all, about yourself, because it's important for us to know the people behind the scenes and the 305, you know, to let them know that they're human beings and that we're all together striving and whatnot. How did you get into the strength and conditioning of combat sports?
So I started working with, by the way, Team Inferno, White Tiger and Dragon Martial Arts, Sensei Carol. Also, shout out to my client, Jafari Stevens. I started working at her gym training clients, and her standout client, Jafari, I began doing his nutrition, tweaking his diet based off his body. So I would do things in particular, like find his BMI and his BMR, and go from there as far as how many grams of protein, fats, and carbs he's able to have to make a certain weight, all right? And then from there, we take an assessment of what is his muscular imbalances, what is his strengths and his weaknesses for the fight, and I write a tailored meal plan and exercise plan based off of the demands that he needs.
Excellent. And that's why you see in our podcast, we have business people coming and talk about the business. We have the fights, talk about the fight game. But today we're talking about strength and conditioning, nutrition. And, you know, one of the things that we're doing in our show is we're educating, we're informing, we're communicating, and we're entertaining. Okay, let's talk about the nutrition. I have a lot of friends in the industry. I've been doing this for a while. And nutrition is at least 50% of the training.
80.
Okay, 80, yeah. 80%. I was being nice. I was going to say 75%. For your fighters, like Jafari, what kind of nutrition do you think is basics important for combat sports?
For combat sports, one thing you want to do, you want to always keep the protein high, because this is the thing. When you're trying to get a person's body to lose more body fat and have more muscle tone, you want to do your protein at least. So, like, say, for example, if you don't mind me asking you, how much do you weigh?
Okay, on a good day, 175.
So you would simply do 175 times 1.2 or 1.4. That sum would be how many grams of protein you need a day to maintain the muscle mass that you have. So now, going forward, if a person wants to be at a surplus or a deficit, that's where you started at, to find out how many grams of protein in a day, how many calories, and then you can tweak in the fats and the carbs. So you do that for them based off the fact that, hey, I want my fighter to maintain muscle while slimming down. Hey, I want my fighter to get a little bit more massy, but keep muscle. So that goes with the filtration in carbs and protein. It's very delicate, but it's all a scientific formula. And I write it based off of the client.
Actually, while you're saying that, I was thinking about also, since they're performing,
right,
they need to have energy.
Right.
So I guess I would assume that they would need carbohydrates for energy, but I guess the right kind of carbohydrates. In other words, combat athletes, what I'm getting from, they need a specific diet. If you're going to do, let's say, a different sport or just bodybuilding, you have to cater a diet to the particulars that you're doing, correct?
Right. So, like, say, use me for an example. I'm an NPC competitor, right? I'm trying to actually go for my pro card. This year, due to COVID, oh, shout out to everybody, far as everybody being safe. If you lost any loved ones, anybody in your family been affected, if you've been affected financially, physically, emotionally, we're continually praying for anybody that has affected you, which I know has affected everyone to a certain standpoint. Me as an NPC bodybuilder, I haven't done any shows this year, but I had planned to go for my pro card to turn pro. So in that world, we do a method called carb cycling. It's the same thing I do for the fighters, meaning on days, if you're not going to exert much energy, your training is mostly calisthenics or more working the bag or working in that aspect. I can drop your carbs a little lower. What that's going to do is it's going to make your body say, hey, this guy's still working out. We need energy from somewhere. So let's get that energy from the fat that's already stored. So now when I give you carbs again, your body is so psyched. It's like, hey, he's still working out. When we get these carbs, let's use them for energy. So now on your heavy compound lifting days, flipping the tire, things of that nature, when you eat those carbohydrates, it's not going to be fat storage. It's going to be for a powerhouse. It's going to be energy.
Excellent. Now you talked about the workout. And I did see a video of Jamari flipping the tires and whatnot. For strength and conditioning, for combat sports, all combat sports, what do you think is the best for that? I know there's a lot of people believe in the HIIT training, the high interval training. Some people believe in lengthening and volume. What's your aspect on that?
I like to mix them all together, being that the fact that HIIT allows you to burn more calories. It's cardiovascular conditioning. At the same time, it's endurance training. Compound lifts, for gosh, you know, grappling on the ground, things of that nature. That's all compound movements. That's using those hips. Your power lies in your lower loins. If you have no power here, you can forget about it. And then as far as actually iso movements, say a thing I like to do a lot is a landmine press where you have the barbell with a grip and you're pressing it here. I make my guys do it from excess of 30 to 20. Why? Because a lot of times if you're doing griping or anything of that nature, you're pushing off. If your shoulders, your interior delts get tired and they're shot, now here's your chance of throwing a punch or wrestling. That's gone. So I have to exhaust these. So now when you're in the ring, it's like, hey, man, I've been exhausted in practice. This is nothing. I'm fine, you know.
I'm glad you bring all these points up because really it's an exciting time in combat sports and in health and working out because now everything's becoming so integrated. We talked about the nutrition. We talked about specific physical training. One of the things also that I like to do and incorporate, and I think it's important later on for recovery and longevity, is like the stretching. And the you would call it the stretching or the physical therapies. Mm-hmm. What is your thought on those?
So I do more of like a mixture of stretch, yoga and corrective exercising. Also, by the way, I have my certification with ISSA for corrective exercising expert. I'm a sports nutrition coach and a personal trainer. That's all through ISSA. Shout out to ISSA. So with corrective exercising, I like to do certain things that would allow me to see where a person's body is lagging at. If you don't mind, I'm gonna demonstrate something, okay?
Excellent. Awesome.
So let's say if I want to know what side of your body is stronger than the other, right? Now I'm a little rusty, so bear with me. If I line my leg up here with my body, okay? My arms are here, right? So I'm squeezing here. My forearms are engaged, my back and my abs. I should be able to turn here. That arm shouldn't drop here. This leg shouldn't move. I should be able to move this arm here, and this arm here goes full range. Now the thing is, it looks simple, but the average person, when they do this, when they turn, that leg may want to go here, this arm may drop, and in a lot of cases, an average person can't raise their delt like this. So it becomes a thing of you wanting to use your head to raise that. Those are all telltale signs to me that a fighter is really tight from his hips, his lats, his deltoids, you name it. So then now I can write a program assess to say, hey, listen, when you throw in this jab or this kick or this roundhouse, you're going to lack power here. Mm-hmm. Let's work out here. So from that assessment upon stretching, I can tell what I need to.
That's excellent. And I love having you and love providing this information for people so it could serve them, like we say, lifelong success.
Right.
You said that's a corrective
exercise. Corrective exercise.
I love that name, corrective exercise. Because being in training and teaching myself, I see some of the time, if you pick what people lack the most, is I wouldn't think the strength and conditioning would be the range of motion and the flexibility.
Range of motion.
Something you said funny is, when you turn like that, how, you could say you wouldn't notice it, but what I notice a bunch is you start tilting.
Right.
To compensate, I guess.
To compensate. So now you got to think about this. Let's translate it into the working environment. If you have all these ailments and you're squatting, and let's say you're ego squatting, you're squatting 225, you're deadlifting, what do you think that's doing to your joints? What do you think that's doing to the muscle imbalance? It's even worse. And let's face it, us as human beings, we're all interior dominant, okay? So everything is computer, drive, cell phone. We're all forward motion. So all of this can be off balance. And now you're gonna go work out, not aware of it, and put more stress on
yes,
it, right?
Yes.
So that's where I come in at before that gets, you know.
Awesome. You know, what I love is that everybody's getting information in all walks of life of all the facets, the holistic and triggered approach about health, which we said the nutrition was the strength and conditioning, mm-hmm. the corrective, the flexibility, the right. therapy. And then that goes into the technical part, you're throwing a hook, a punch, learning the technique.
Right.
This is awesome. I want to take advantage right now. What is your social media handle?
My social media handle is KMar underscore Fitness Miami. Again, that's KMar underscore Fitness Miami.
Excellent. All the strength and conditioning, all the physical therapists out there, much respect to you. If you need information or you want our platform, you can contact 305fights.tv. Any shout out to any particular people that you want to give out to?
Like I said, Sensei Carol, my client Jafari Stevenson, we got a fight September 26th, 305 Fights. You make sure you get that pay-per-view. And also shout out to Evergen Nutrition as well as Hero Hera.
Excellent. To all the schools, all the martial arts schools, all the coaches, regardless of style, regardless of politics, respect and honor to you. We're promoting everybody together. White Tiger and Dragon, Inferno.
Team Inferno.
Yes. All the nutritional supplements, NutriPro out there, Senior Velo, HXP Nutrition. I want to thank Miami Media. We have our artist Angel Baby on the wings, and we talk about the music and the entertainment. We have Jonathan over the voice of Worldwide 305. Everybody that's, you know, like yourself, we've had such a reception and such a positive energy behind 305 Fights. I just want to thank everybody for appreciating us and motivating and sponsoring us. Make sure you get that pay-per-view September
26th.
Jafari, shout out to him, to all the fighters. Quisiera dar toda la información y todas las gracias a todo el mundo en 305 por apoyarnos, el apoyo que tenemos de los tutores, de los maestros. Si necesita información sobre nutrición, what's your information again?
At KMar underscore Fitness Miami.
Si no, nos contacta 305.tv. Te damos toda la información para mejorar tu salud, tu vida. September 26, número 9. 305 Fights, where the champions rise. 305 Fights is where the champions rise. 305, donde surgen los campeones. What a champion ride!